New tonight, WESH 2 investigates a sneaky fee buried on the bills at a new restaurant. Curious customers came to us after seeing they were being charged an extra 1% on their tabs at the new Miller's Ale House at the corner of 1792 and Lee Road. It's labeled as a personal usage fee and includes the property's name. Travell Island live there tonight. So, Travell, you found out this extra fee is perfectly legal.
Yeah, it's perfectly legal, Sian, as long as they don't call it a tax. Here it is, right here at the bottom of the receipt. Ravadash PUF, or personal usage fee, and it's basically a charge to keep that place looking nice and pretty, but you would never know you were being charged for it unless you look very closely. Food is a top priority when dining out. Enjoy the lobster, did you take a look at your bill?
Yes, it was in the 30s.
But customers at the new Miller's Ale House in Winter Park may want to inquire about what's on their tab. We got a tip about unusual charges at the restaurant and went to check it out. I ordered the Ale House combo, $10.99, and a soda for $2.49. The waitress told me about the specials, but not about the fee I found buried at the bottom of the bill. Ravadash PUF. The total, 13 cents, 1% of my tab. Customers we talked to never saw the charge either.
I didn't realize that, and then I scrutinized the bill.
Well, they should post something, at least to let you know what you're paying for in the end.
We saw plenty of signs posted, but nothing about the extra fee. The manager told me the Ravadash charge comes from the property developer. The restaurant passes it along as a maintenance fee to customers.
Yeah.
About 30 cents for us.
Yeah.
Well, now, I'll have to take that off the tip next time.
Pretty underhanded. I think that you should be told. And so you can make the decision of whether it's worth 1% to you to eat here.
The Ale House manager says the fee will pay for the upkeep of the lawn and pay for the piping used to build the property.
Sounds like a tax.
But it's not a tax. It's a fee. And by law, the local government can't stop the developer from charging it.
To be taken off if we noticed it.
Right. Yeah. She would.
Yes. I'm not bashful.
Well, the person who built this place is the prominent Winter Park developer, Dan Bellows. We reached out to him via phone and email. We haven't heard back from him at this time, so it's going to be up to customers to decide if they want to pay the fee and eat here. For now, we're live in Winter Park. Travell Island, WESH 2 News.